Good morning. I just want to thank Reverend Fidler for allowing me this opportunity to speak in front of you all today. Not gonna lie, I'm really nervous right now. But anyways, several months ago, I was having a lesson with one of my tennis coaches. We got to talking about the mental side of the game. He has a unique style of coaching me in this regard. He first shares his life experiences with me, then challenges me to think for myself to understand his point. This process can often be more draining than the lesson itself. During that lesson, he asked me, if you could have one thing, anything in the world, what would it be? I paused for a moment, but the answer is pretty obvious to me. If I could have one thing, anything in the world, I would choose happiness. It may sound cliche, but that was the first thought that came to mind. It's odd to think that something that seems so basic can really be a lot more complex. How much time do we really spend thinking about what really makes us happy? My thoughts went immediately to my dad. He has always shared with me his belief about how the meaning of life is happiness. He's clear to point out that it's unrealistic to achieve complete happiness since no one can really be happy at every moment of the day. We face constant challenges in life that create peaks and valleys. They're inevitable. However, he stresses that I should strive to achieve maximum happiness in everyday life. There's an approach he shared with me in order to accomplish this. In his philosophy, there are two components for maximizing happiness, physical and emotional well-being. Think of it in terms of a diagram. At the top is the goal, maximizing happiness, and below are two branches that are equally important. On one side, there's physical well-being, and beside it is the emotional well-being component. Under each of those two components, there are three subcategories. Simply, the physical components require a healthy diet, exercise, and sleep. However, I'd like to focus this morning on the emotional well-being aspect to maximizing happiness. The three subcategories needed for emotional well-being are healthy relationships, enjoying what you do, and having some kind of a belief system. Healthy relationships are the positive interactions we have with other people. These include interactions with our family, friends, classmates, teachers. Think about how much time we really spend around other people. If these interactions are negative, they can drain us emotionally. Imagine having these negative feelings day after day. In contrast, when we surround ourselves with healthy relationships, then we experience positive energy. This also provides a sense of security for us. Our spirits can be lifted with the positive energy. The relationships we have with others can either drag us down or lift us up. It only makes sense to try and have good interactions with those around us. It's especially important to build strong relationships with those closest to us. The second requirement for achieving emotional well-being is doing what you love to do. There are 24 hours in a day, and the majority of it we spend here at school. Other people go to college or have a job. The point is that we all have a daily routine. Ours happens to be school. I get that we really don't have much of a choice at this stage in our lives. We all kind of have to be here. However, we do have some kind of ownership over our schedules. There are electives and extracurriculars that we can choose from. I get that there's so much pressure to go to a certain summer program, participate in elite level sports, and be an outstanding artist because it looks good on our college apps. And that's fine, but just make sure that whatever it is that you're investing yourself in is something that you truly enjoy doing. Why invest your time and effort in something if you don't genuinely enjoy it? If you want to do a summer program at your dream school, make the most of it and enroll in a program that genuinely interests you. Doing what you enjoy doing is so important. Imagine how difficult it'd be to get up early in the morning, sit in traffic, and go to an 8-hour job that you don't really enjoy. That's at least a third of your day spent in a dreaded environment. When you enjoy what you do, you'll also do a better job at it. There's a saying my dad's told me, and I'm sure you'll all have heard it, but if you love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life. The third factor in achieving emotional well-being is having some kind of a belief system. A belief system is a way in which we try to make sense of the world around us. Things happen every day that seem so irrational and don't make sense. There's wars, mass shootings, natural disasters. We struggle daily to try and make sense of these events. A belief system allows us to rationalize them. There are different types of belief systems. There's religion, superstition, mentors, even fate. People who rely on religion turn to prayer during difficult times. Others who believe in fate just take things as they come. Regardless of what your belief system is, I think it's important to have one. Without it, a person just drifts without any direction. It's more challenging to overcome daily struggles if you're just drifting in your negative thoughts. A belief system gives us hope. Hope convinces us that a tough time will pass. It gives us a sense of direction during difficult moments, really. A few years ago, Dr. Edith Edgar visited our school. I'll never forget the vivid story she shared about being held in a concentration camp during the Holocaust. I kept wondering where she found the strength to survive. She shared that she always kept hope. Dr. Edgar is an example of how a belief system can sustain us in even the most difficult moments. In our daily lives, a belief system is a powerful tool for achieving emotional well-being. Our daily lives are so hectic. It's true that we aren't in control of absolutely everything. We're bound to have a rough day or two. However, we can have control over our emotional well-being. We just need to focus on good relationships, do what we love to do, and rely on a belief system. We're more in control than we may think. We are in control of maximizing happiness. Thank you.